Our big story at noon, the Baltimore City Police Department is honoring a fallen officer who died from injuries sustained while on duty. 11 News reporter Nadia Ramdas is live outside the Cathedral of Mary Our Queen in North Baltimore with the details. Nadia.
Good afternoon, Sarah. Well, as you can imagine, this was just a very emotional day here as colleagues, family, and friends came out here to celebrate the life of this man. Now, funeral services are going on as we speak here behind me, and it's expected to wrap up relatively soon. Officer Forrest Taylor is the first member of the department to die in the line of duty this year, and his supervisors tell us his death is a tremendous loss to the department. In a tribute fit for a fallen hero, a motorcade brings the man who Baltimore City police say always put his life on the line to keep the streets safe.
Say Baltimore is a safer city because of his work.
44-year-old Officer Forrest Taylor died from injuries he suffered in a crash back in February. Officer Taylor was en route to a call to assist a fellow officer when his cruiser collided with
And he never really recovered from the accident. He went through a whole series of medical procedures and surgeries, and he passed in August, and he's the first officer this year that has died in the line of duty.
Besides being an ordained minister, Officer Taylor was a member of the Archangels Riders Motorcycle Club of Elk Ridge. Members of the club were on hand to escort the urn Holland Taylor's ashes to the Cathedral of Mary Our Queen in North Baltimore for a final farewell and salute. Taylor was also a husband and a father of a 7-year-old son and 5-year-old daughter who made their way to the church on this somber day.
The unexpected nature of this, you know, with the accident and him never recovering, it's just been a very, very difficult situation for them. It's been difficult for us internally in the department, but for the family, it's just a tremendous, tremendous loss.
Officer Taylor was admired by many of his colleagues. He was known for taking on tough assignments and even mentoring younger officers. A tremendous loss to the department and community.
I think he is a testament and an example of really what it takes to have a dedicated long career. 17 years doing all those difficult assignments. He is the example of commitment.
Now, once the services wrap up here, Taylor's funeral procession will head to Annapolis, where that will be his final resting place, his hometown. We're live in North Baltimore this afternoon. Nadia Ramdas, WBAL-TV 11 News.